guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to be doing a music video reaction, and I think the last time I did a music video reaction on my channel was probably over a month ago, so I'm glad that I'm finally getting around to doing this. I feel like you mainly will know about Olivia Rodrigo if you're on TikTok, because there was that whole like beef or whatever between Olivia Rodrigo and Sabrina Carpenter, and they were kind of doing songs back and forth. So I don't know if this new song of hers is going to be kind of like another, if it's going to be another like argument towards Sabrina, or I just have a feeling it's going to be about her ex-boyfriend and like about heartbreak and all that kind of stuff, because I feel like that's what she mainly sings about in her songs. So yeah, that's what I'm expecting today. I'm kind of hoping she goes for something different, because as much as I like her music and I kind of love the whole like breakup, sad love life kind of theme in her songs, I would like to see her do something different. But it's called Good For You. I'm assuming it's going to be about love of some kind. But anyway, let's just get to it. This is Olivia Rodrigo, Good For You, and I'm going to be reacting to it. Oh my god, her eye shape is so pretty. Imagine not having bags. Can't relate. What is that? Is that a mirror phone? What the heck? I've never seen anything like that before.
Good for you, I guess you moved on really easily. You found a new girl and it only took a couple weeks. Remember when you said that you wanted to give me the world? And good for you, I guess that you've been working on yourself. I guess the therapist I found for you, she really helped. Now you can be a better man for your brand new girl.
Okay, sorry, stopping her. So actually, I don't think any of her songs have been like this. It's kind of giving me a little bit of rock, but you know, kind of like, I don't know if you guys remember, but you know, in like the 2010s, 2007s, songs quite often had that rocky vibe to it. I think that was just quite common in that kind of era, genre type thing. So it's kind of giving me like, you know, throwback 2000s rocky vibes. I'm kind of living for it. But obviously, as I assumed, it's a love song, or it's to do with, not a love song, but it's to do with like breakups and like getting over someone and that kind of theme. I was expecting it, but I really, really can't wait until she brings out a completely different song of a completely different style, not to do with love or anything like that. I just kind of want to see what it would be like. But this song definitely caters to a lot of people, because I feel like, you know, love songs or breakup songs, a lot of people relate to them, so they do a lot better. Oh my god, they do a lot better for some reason. They get a lot more views. So yeah, makes sense really.
Good for you, I guess you're getting everything you want.
Oh,
got a new car and your career's really taking
off. That part was so good.
It never even happened, baby. What the fuck is up with that? And good for you, it's like you never even met me. Remember when you swore to God I was the only person who ever got. Well, screw that. Screw you. You will never have to hurt the way you know that I do. Well, good for you. You look happy and healthy. Not me. If you ever cared to ask. Good for you. You're doing great out there without me, baby. God, I wish that I could do that. I'm the small boy who spent the night crying on the floor of my bedroom. Just so unaffected. I really don't get it. I guess good for you.
I'm sorry. That line, I think she said, I don't get how you're so unaffected, but good for you. Bro, you might as well just at me at this point, because I relate to that so much. But honestly, it's so true. Like, how do people go from being like, you're my world, like, I love you so much, I want to marry you, to literally being so unaffected over a breakup? Like, how did you go from one extreme to another? But like, good for you, because I kind of wish I was on that level, you know? Like, I completely get what she's saying. Pain. I really like this.
Maybe I'm too emotional, but your apathy's like a wounded soul. Maybe I'm too emotional, maybe you never cared at all.
Yes.
Maybe I'm too emotional, your apathy is like
felt. Queen, oh my god, that was such a tune. Bro, this is going straight on my playlist. I'm gonna be screaming this at 3 in the morning. Don't ask why. Just don't do it. Honestly, I really like that last clip. I really enjoyed this music video, but especially the last bit where she's like standing in a room that's full of water and there's fire behind her. I don't know why, but that just looks so fun. Like, I want to do that. That just looks so powerful. But anyway, I hope you guys have enjoyed this reaction. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe if you have enjoyed. I do reactions, I do hauls, vlogs, depending on how I'm feeling. If you've watched any of my other videos that aren't reactions, you'll know that I do a little bit more editing in those videos, you know, make it a little bit more, not interactive, but maybe a bit more interesting to watch. I kind of like adding zooms and stuff and sound effects and all that kind of stuff to my videos. So if that's something you enjoy, make sure to subscribe, and hopefully I'll see you in my next video. Bye!